Luther, stay here and protect the cabin. I'm going after him.
Samuel stared at his father, his eyes wide. The boy was very pale, but he seemed unafraid. Only then did O'Brien see the scarlet splash of blood on his son's left arm.
Are you wounded, Samuel?
He got grazed by a ball, Colonel. Come clean through the door. One of them Indians using a Sharp's Big 50, I reckon.
O'Brien stepped to the door, but then he looked back.
Samuel, are you sure you're all right?
I'm fine, Pa.
Luther?
I know what to do, Colonel.
There was nothing more to be said. O'Brien slid back the door's wooden bolt and charged into the tumbling snow and the wild wolf wind. O'Brien, his rifle up and ready, moved to the corner of the cabin in a crouching walk. His eyes searched into the snowstorm, but his visibility was only limited to a few yards around him. He saw no Apaches. Walking carefully.